A man named Major Brent Taylor sent a message from Afghanistan that was meant for all of us. Take a listen to a little bit of it. It was beautiful to see over 4 million Afghan men and women brave threats and deadly attacks to vote in Afghanistan's first parliamentary elections in 8 years. I hope everyone back home exercises their precious right to vote, and that whether the Republicans or the Democrats win, that we all remember that we have far more as Americans that unites us than divides us. United we stand, divided we fall. God bless America. Now, Taylor's job was to secure those parliamentary elections in Afghanistan. And he saw that struggle, literally life and death, and it made him appreciate what so many here take for granted. Taylor knew our political system well, not just as a soldier, but as a politician. He won the race for mayor of his hometown, North Ogden, Utah. I have three arguments in favor of listening to the major. First, he's right. Barely half of the eligible population here votes. That is embarrassing in a place that's supposed to be a bastion of democracy. Second, Taylor is a reminder that our current leaders have thousands of our men and women in Afghanistan. The place is called the Graveyard of Empires for a reason. And what they're telling you are advise and assist missions. That may sound benign, but it's a deception. Know that, that our leaders are giving us an idea that is false. Now, the biggest reason of all is that the Facebook message that Taylor sent us is the last one he ever sent. Major Taylor was killed in Afghanistan in what they call an insider attack, meaning that one of those he was advising and assisting took the life of this 39-year-old National Guardsman, his public servant. They stole a husband from Jenny, his wife, and a father from those 7 kids. Now, by all accounts, Taylor did not consider himself special, but he was. He served country and community and family in a way that few of us could ever match. And his last message was done to awaken a sense of duty in all of us. We don't have to go fight like he did. We don't have to be heroes. We get to do something easy. We use the precious right that we take for granted. You know, when we lose people who matter to us, we often struggle with how to honor them in their passing. We did that after the synagogue shooting most recently. We talked about the Jews' deep beliefs in making the world better, in charity. And maybe we should consider thinking more about how we direct our own energy in positive directions in their memory. Well, given this loss, I can't think of any more powerful gesture than honoring Taylor's sacrifice by doing what he asked. Vote. Let those elected know we bring you in and we'll take you out. And maybe, just maybe, if you come out in big numbers, not only will we prove to ourselves that we're respecting our hard-fought franchise, sending a message to lawmakers that we, the people, are their proper focus, but hopefully, a family in Utah whose husband and father and mayor were taken far too soon, the message will also be that his sacrifice mattered back home. Thank you to Major Taylor for the message and for the service and the sacrifice. May he rest in peace. Our condolences to Jenny, his wife, and to his children, Megan, Lincoln, Alex, Jacob, Ellie, Jonathan, and 11-month-old Caroline. You should all know and tell your sister when she gets older, your father is a hero. For the rest of us, tomorrow, go vote.